On today's episode of the Relationship Status Podcast, the crew talk about the first date. They discuss the approach. Nique says that women are more inclined to shoot their shot now. CL says that men have allowed women to take a lot of male energy. Yusuf gets deep in his bag. CL says Yusuf is cooking with gas. The guys try to put numbers on Nique, and CL says he does not give the full CL-ism on the first date. And of course, the Ask Nique segment. Here's the crew, CL, Nique, and Yusuf.
The following podcast is being brought to you by the Defy Life Podcast Network.
Yeah, yeah, it is. She caught me by surprise, I must say, 'cause I never have seen such a pretty face with such a warm and beautiful smile. It wasn't hard for me to notice her style. I was fascinated, surely. She took my heart and held it for me. I wouldn't let her get away, not until she heard me say,
"Excuse me, miss, what's your name? Where are you from? Can I come and possibly
can I take you out tonight?
To the movies, to the park, I'll have you home for a start. So let me know,
can I take you out tonight?"
Welcome to the Relationship Podcast. It's your girl, Nique Cruz.
CL Butler.
And your boy, Yusuf.
And today's episode is about the first date. Where should we start?
The approach.
The approach?
The approach.
What about the approach?
Oh, it needs to be as non-threatening as possible.
Non-threatening?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You don't want to scare her away?
Yeah, you don't want to scare her away.
Well, also about women approaching men for the first date.
Okay. Where you want us? Ladies first?
Ladies first.
Ladies first.
This is ladies first. This is 2019, ladies first.
2019 edition.
Yeah.
Yes, ladies are approaching men. We are shooting our shot.
Okay, so you are the lady of the room.
Yeah, I'm the only lady in the room.
Hey, we don't know how people identify. We really don't. Not yourself, but we don't know how people identify.
I was gonna look over there.
What do you mean?
I kind of identify as a little person, so.
I identify as a little person too.
See? We do identify the same.
Two ends of the spectrum.
Yes, two way different ends of the spectrum. Okay, well, let's talk about how the ladies approaching.
I think we now, in 2018, 2019, we started approaching men and shooting our shots and asking men out on dates. And
I got a question about that, though. Like, what do you think brought that about?
I believe women got tired of sitting back waiting for a man to approach her.
Oh, wow.
Oh. Mm. Well, because I know, what, maybe about couple decades ago, it was seen
what,
as little.
The 99 in 2000?
No, before the 99 in 2000. Back in the 80s.
80s,
it
okay.
It was seen as type HOR-ish.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
A little bit of, you know, a little bit of extraness.
Okay.
So, no, it just, I don't know. I've always been baffled at when the change happened. Like, what made it socially.
I think when men stop being as credible.
That makes sense.
As they should have been.
Sense.
Yeah. Yeah. Like it's our fault.
It's our fault.
It's our fault. We dropped the ball a little bit.
Oh, how?
I bet.
Allowing women to take on a lot of male energy.
True.
Like women having to maybe, I'm going to use tradition here, but men stop being traditional men. Not in every aspect, but some aspects didn't really need to change, in my opinion. I agree.
So you feel like that since women took on more male roles, sort of in the household and everything else.
Well, men assumed when women said they wanted more, they wanted the male more too. They just wanted more for women. They didn't necessarily want to be the man.
But I mean, do you think some of it has to do with the boom in absentee males in the household?
Definitely has some effect on it. Not the only effect, but some effect.
You know, women, more women in the workforce, meaning more.
More income, more responsibility.
Yeah, taking on the opposite gender role.
It does give you a boost of confidence of, I'm going to go after what I want. And if I want him, I'm going to go after him.
All ladies aren't making good choices out here.
Oh, no.
You say we're making good choices.
They've gotten us in some holes now. I mean, some different areas now. But
I do believe, a lot of women are tired of sitting back waiting for a man to approach them.
What about being patient?
Patience is a virtue.
It's a virtue. This is true. But you know what? I've had some men even approach and say, I've approached some men and be like, oh, I never knew I was your type. So, I mean, hey.
Do you have a type?
Hey, I ain't got no type.
No type.
I can't say I do, but I tell some men that too when they approach me, like, I didn't know I was your type.
Oh, wow. Wow.
So,
didn't know you're a woman. He likes women. Like, what is the type? Like,
what is the type?
Does he have a height requirement? Or
that might be it.
He might. Okay. He might doesn't like short women.
Has to be this tall to ride the ride, I guess.
Yeah, you gotta be this height.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Okay. So see, like, best approach to a date, like to get to the date.
Now, okay.
What do you think the best way to approach it?
To approach a woman.
Yeah, to get
now,
it to
the, we have to build some ambiance here. Let's find out exactly where we are in this situation.
Turn lights down low.
We're going to see where we at. Now, do you know her? Or is this a cold call?
Cold call. Let's start with the cold call.
Okay, cold call. You just hollering. You already
I done seen her in the mall.
In the wilderness.
Your shot for the first time.
I done seen her in the mall. Yo, what's up, shout?
Oh, wow. Not Charlie.
Don't I dare.
Oh, no.
I had a homeboy at college. Yeah. His call was, get you.
Get you?
Get you.
Wow.
Get you.
Is he married?
Girl.
Is he?
Here, girl.
Here. Is she a pet? What are you talking about? Here, girl.
Is she a whore?
He's from Atlanta. Shouts out to my man.
Wow.
He's from Atlanta. He would go, no matter where we were, if he saw a girl thought was cute, get you. Here, girl. Get you. Now, oddly enough.
I hope he got what he wanted when somebody responded to that.
Oddly enough. He had more responses than denials.
Okay.
Oddly enough. Dang. Now, mind you, could never work for me.
It's the Wild
for
Wild him, West out here.
For him, it was,
I'm lying, because I want to see these women that accept it.
I don't know what went for
the putting up numbers?
He was putting up.
He was doing well.
Oh, my man put up numbers, man.
Wow.
He had to be cute.
Hey, listen, I just, that's his approach. But cold call.
Cold call.
What's up, girl?
I think you start with hello.
Yeah.
Hello?
Is it me you're looking
Introduce
for?
Yourself. Make direct eye contact.
Mm-hmm.
Don't touch her.
No.
Don't touch her.
Don't touch her. Don't touch can make someone feel uncomfortable very quickly.
What I found, just like from my last, a woman can touch a guy.
Yes.
And it'd be totally different than if a man touches
Absolutely.
A woman.
Absolutely.
I just find it odd.
Because I think there are more men that can hurt women physically than women can hurt men physically.
Men are more aggressive.
Oh, they are. Some men aren't very aggressive?
Yeah. You may think you're being gentle by, grabbing my arm.
Oh, no, I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about as you have the initial hello.
Now, you don't know her.
Yeah, you don't know her.
If you don't know her, don't touch her at all.
I mean, like, you'll have some men that will grab your arm to get your attention.
Well, no, I ain't talking about that. That I know you're liable to get slapped. That I'm not worried about.
Mm-hmm.
That I'm not talking about. I'm talking about we have gotten past the hello.
Mm-hmm.
And we're having some.
So you said a fast mover. You moving fast. Wow.
You didn't touch her.
You responded yet to her name. Like,
oh no, I don't need to know her name yet.
Okay.
So you touching already?
I didn't say I was touching.
Oh.
Okay.
I'm just saying you're in the. She's engaged in the brief conversation that you're having,
mm-hmm.
and it might be a light touch on the shoulder, or a laugh, or something like that. Not grabbing her hand or violently. Trying to get her attention, but it's like a touch of the shoulder or a laugh or something like that.
No touching.
Okay, I'm just listening.
Yeah, I would say no touching, but
I'm not saying it's me. I'm just asking questions.
You could attempt to start with something witty or clever.
Telling a joke?
Like a knock knock? Or there's a, there was a nun, a priest, and a cowboy or something like that? No, I don't think you should go that route. What you can say is, you know, it's funny meeting you here. Okay. Well, glad to see you here again.
True.
Because you now you can let her know you've been watching her. Like, I've seen you a few times.
But if this is a cold call.
It's a cold call.
What about a pickup line?
Well, it's a lie. I mean, it's a cold call. I mean,
it's a cold call.
You got to do what you got to do to get in the game. Hey.
Pickup line?
Yeah.
A pickup line? Like, what's your name? What's your sign?
Mm-hmm.
That's a classic now.
No.
A woman of a certain age, it may work.
No, I got one more classic than that. There's one more classic than that.
What's that?
Your feet must be hurt, must be tired, baby.
Oh, wow.
You've been running through my mind.
Oh, dang. Oh yeah. It's a player. Yeah. It's a player.
Like, does that actually work?
Somebody mama got somebody got like that. Somebody. I don't know. If you said that to me, I'd be like, I'm good. I'm good.
I don't know. I've never been like with pickup lines. I never had.
Women don't need an approach. Yeah. They just need to
I mean like men approaching. Like I ain't never.
Never a good one?
Nah, not no corny ones.
You ain't never got hit with a corny line?
Mm-mm. No.
Nobody accidentally bumped into you?
Oh, here we go. Here we go. Hey, girl, you dropped something. What? Our conversation.
Oh, why?
Oh, God.
Yeah. Well, you digging in your bag. You in your bag today. You deep in your bag. Wow.
He's like cracking up at his own joke.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow. My God, yeah.
No? That wouldn't work?
Nah.
Oh.
Nah, it sounds corny. Just a simple hello.
Sometimes corny is okay, though.
But if you can spin it.
Yeah,
if you can make yourself, like, if you can make her laugh with you and not at you, I think that would be the best approach. But, I mean, hello, just a simple hello, how you doing, mm-hmm. What's your name, I think would get anybody.
I think being polite mm-hmm. opens the door.
Okay. So now we've been polite.
Mm-hmm.
We've engaged her.
Okay.
She's in it.
She's in it. She's feeling it.
She's feeling
better
it.
Better not touch.
She's feeling the vibe.
She's feeling the vibe. Okay. Right. Now.
Y'all vibing.
I'm going to go into my personal playbook here.
Going to personal playbook.
I would just give her my number. I wouldn't take her number.
Just give it to her.
I give her my number.
Well, here you go. What do you say?
This is for you.
This is for you.
You walk around with business cards with your number?
I have a calling card. Nondescript calling card. Just name and number, email address.
I've had many.
Just a card.
Yeah. Just a card. Name, number.
Name, number, email address. You can use
some have their social media on it.
Yeah.
So, these are personal.
This is a personal calling card. This is different from my business cards.
Not a business card.
That's why I'm giving you a personal card.
But
wouldn't business.
But wouldn't the question be, why you walk around with all these damn daggone cards?
That ain't none of her business.
Well, first of all, you need to call me so you can find out.
Okay, I got you.
So, once I tell her that, then it strikes you gotta be a little mysterious, a little curiosity, and then you build from there.
I got you.
So you just approach her, ask her her name, and say, here's my number.
No, not that. No. I'd be a little more casual. Maybe... You don't want to go anything over 2 minutes.
Okay. You don't want to be engaged in more than 2 minutes?
Nah.
It's a little too much.
Give it to her, walk away. Let the fantasy begin. Oh, God.
And she'd be like, I wonder what kind of person he is.
Yeah.
Let me call.
You're building the mysteriousness about you.
Okay, so after she calls you. And then you walk.
Hold on a second now. This is the key.
Uh-huh.
Go in the next most expensive store. That you walk by. Just walk in there.
So you're not being yourself.
I'm actually being myself. I'm just not going to buy nothing. I'm being myself. I look in all these stores. What's he doing in there?
As long as it's not Victoria's Secret.
No, it can't be a woman's. It's got to be.
A man's store? Or just a basic
store?
Listen,
it could just... It needs to be one of those stores in the mall that you don't go in. And that's where you should go in.
Okay.
Yeah. Because if it's a store you don't go in, you kind of guarantee you ain't
going
to
buy. You don't want to go into Champs. That don't say nothing. Like, oh, you want Champs.
Yeah, he's a guy. He likes shoes.
Nah, you need to go in like a exotic yarn store or something like that. You know, something. A candle
candles,
shop.
Yeah.
Candles. Like, you in the candles?
Like, oh.
Yeah. See that? Now you're building. It's a slow build up. You're putting the foundation.
Curiosity.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then that comes back which I'll call back later and tell you why you did it then, as we go on further into our conversation.
Yes. She's gonna wanna know.
Yes.
So after she calls.
So she's now we on the phone.
Yeah, now we're on the phone.
She done called me.
She's interested.
Okay.
Hit the seven digits.
Now, how long before you decide? Because some guys just straight go date mode.
No.
We need to get together.
I think.
Well, first.
Uh-huh.
As a woman, it will be like how long before I call him, because I don't want to make him feel
too thirsty.
Like, yeah, I don't want to seem too thirsty. So thirst I may not call you thing, that same
I
got some day. Water.
I give it a week. Wow. Wow.
What?
Hey. Wow.
I did not
this
hear
guy.
It.
This guy. Wow. You have to listen to that one on the playback. Wow.
I can't wait.
Wow. You got it, huh?
Wow.
Wow.
He got the juice. Yeah.
He got it.
I'm sorry, y'all, man. It's been a long day.
He's got the juice. He's got it. He's got what they need.
Well, but I usually do give it a couple of days. Not a week, but...
A week? I always
I'll give it a day or two.
Only two to
like
seven?
Like, if it's a Friday, I will call on a Sunday.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, why a Sunday? Or no particular...
Well, I would say a Sunday at a certain time, just to... Like, I don't know what you're doing that weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And... If I want to call you and actually, you know, get to know you and ask you questions, I want to make sure you're not entirely too busy. And usually on Sundays, people rest.
Okay.
I would say I very few times do I agree. But, Nique, I agree.
You agree. Okay.
I think
Sunday's that, a wind down.
Well, mm-hmm. I wouldn't. When you're talking about strategy in a call,
mm-hmm.
you want to be able to get that person's best, them.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And the most open that they might be. So, a call during the week, no.
Yeah.
Because you don't know what hours they work.
Okay.
And so, you don't want to call at a time where they go, just got off work, got to feed the kids or got to eat.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, got some work to do, I'll call you back. So, Friday, if they're single...
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to go into the Friday evening type of thing, because they may, if it's a female, oh, I go out with my girls on Friday night.
Mm-hmm.
Saturdays, sometime usually family stuff or going out and this, that, and the third, so I don't choose Saturdays.
Yeah, you don't know what
but
they
a Sunday
have
afternoon, 4 or 5-ish.
That usually?
Church. Yeah, after church, after dinner. They done ate early. I said, at 8 early.
Yeah. Uh-huh. They done ate already.
Yeah.
Kind of settle down and prepare for the day.
Yeah, between that 5 to 7, you can get a good conversation, and before you tell them, hey, look.
So that's the one woman's courtesy call?
Yeah.
Because you know what the next calls are going to be.
What's that?
Just random, late, early. Just trying to see what you got going on.
Yeah.
But by that first
after 10?
Well, I mean,
first conversation, you'll start to know that person's, like, well, when you call, he's going to be like, hey, you know, I wasn't sure what you were doing, but I just wanted to call. You gave me your number.
Mm-hmm.
And usually men will say, oh, it's fine. You know, I'm just getting prepared for the week, for the work week, et cetera, and go into their schedule. So then you have an idea of where they work at, or, you know, that's kind of a icebreaker there for conversation wise on the phone. Like, okay, you work here. Oh, what are your hours?
Well, I think.
Go ahead, see.
Personally.
All right.
I would talk a couple minutes and tell her I got to call her back.
Oh, a couple of minutes.
Yeah, a couple minutes. I was just reading my Bible. I'm going to finish up here and pray, and then I'm going to call you back.
That's going to go through one ear, not the other. I'm going to say, oh, okay.
Well, I mean, you heard. As long as you hear me. It don't matter if you retain it. Just as long as you heard me. And I'm going to get back with you. I need about 20 minutes, you know. Because I want you to know my spiritual side. See, now I've established interest and spirituality, which are very important things to women.
No, the best.
I did the research.
The best you could have did, no, is just say, hey, I just got home from church.
No. I'm praying and reading my Bible right now.
Or now, I've heard guys say.
How are you going to diss somebody reading their Bible? All you can say is, okay.
I've heard guys say, like for to get off the phone, like, hey, you know, I'm about to go to bed, I gotta get ready for to prepare for work tomorrow, and then I have to read my Bible. And
no, that but like, that's regular.
Yeah,
this is our first conversation. I want you to know how close God is to me. So I'm gonna say, listen,
I'm about to read
I'm excited
Bible.
About your phone call, but I need to finish
Oh, that's right. She's calling you.
She called me. I'm building. I'm building.
All right.
Building.
Yeah.
Giving you the steps.
I remember.
You know what I'm saying?
She called you. All right. So that makes sense.
Okay. So.
That makes sense.
So how long did you give her? Well, how long did it take to call her back?
I'm going to finish reading my Bible. Probably about 20 minutes. Then I'm going to call her back.
Okay.
And now she's got a few questions to ask me.
She already had a few questions to ask.
No, she's got more. She's going to ask me about that store. Then she's going to ask me about my Bible. Maybe where I go to church.
Mm-hmm.
Then I can lead into, see where she at. So you're building the foundation to create a conversation.
Okay.
Okay.
That makes sense.
That makes sense.
Put way too much thought into this.
Yeah.
Way.
Now, I would have gone a different route outside of the Bible, but
okay.
If I was gonna play it off like in that sense,
no one's playing about the Bible. But go ahead.
No. I'm not playing. No, I mean
I'm
like
just saying, just in case somebody interpreted it that way.
Oh no. We don't believe that CL is playing about the Bible. By no means.
Okay.
I would probably use, hey, do you mind if I gave you a call back?
Okay.
I'm on the phone with my mom.
Now you look like that a mama work. Boy.
That, no, you don't look like work. A mama's boy. It's a Sunday.
That could work.
It's a Sunday. I'm talking to my mom, which is establishing that I have a relationship with my mom.
Mm. Curiosity.
So, exactly.
Spirituality.
And
mamas? Who can go wrong with mamas?
And my mom is it's not that she's a huge priority, but right now, if you're calling me and I say, hey, hold on.
So you let her know that you already prioritized.
Yeah.
If she wants to move in that side, she got to.
Bingo. See, if I cut off, hey, hold on one second.
Ladies, are you listening?
Yeah.
Hold on one second. And then come back, I had to get off the phone and ask my mom. So now I'm giving you.
That's solid.
Yeah. So what I would say, hey, I'm on the phone with my mom real quick. I'll call you as soon as I'm done with the soon as I'm done talking to her.
Okay.
Now, Nique, what would a woman do?
So now, hold on. So now, guess what that brings up.
He's
now.
Not finished.
Okay. Guess what that brings up now.
You never finish. Can't stop.
Does your mom live here?
Okay.
No, she lives in.
Oh, wow. Usually men, I mean, if a man calls me first.
It's no pressure for women. Women don't have to do nothing.
Yeah, it's not hard. It's okay. Like, hey, how are you doing? If I'm busy, hey, I'm going to call you back. Okay, fine. And I'll call him back whenever I get the time to call him back.
Okay.
There's no, okay, I'm going to give him 20 minutes, make him wonder and think. No, because if he approached me, that means he's interested. I already got his attention.
Okay. So women definitely have less work to do than we do.
Yeah. Much effort into it.
You better. Because you don't want nobody getting bored.
But no, it's not bored. Like, we don't have to play those games.
It's not a game. I'm serious. This is really the reality. It's not a game.
But I mean, like, do I get my number? No, I don't really give my number out. I take numbers. I'm like, oh, put your number in my phone.
See, you know what would be another good one to use?
What's that? Not use, just something.
Something that just is the truth.
Give the brothers a good word.
They play games.
No. Hey, I'm about to record my podcast real quick.
Okay, let them know you into podcasting.
I'm about to record my podcast. I'll call you when we done.
Now you're showing you more interesting.
Yeah. What's your podcast about? Where can I listen to your podcast?
Wow.
You know what?
Wow.
I'm just saying.
You billboard. You cooking with gas.
You know what's so crazy about that? I'll have men say, oh my God, you have a podcast? Really? Oh, where can I listen? And that's where they'll start a conversation with me.
So this podcast is helping you. Wow.
It's coaxing.
Wow.
Definitely. So
okay.
So once you are on the phone,
ask? That's once you're on the phone, go ahead, Nique.
Yeah, I was gonna ask, how long before you ask about the first date?
I like to get anywhere from 6 to 15 hours of phone conversation in.
Okay, so a couple of days?
No. I might take a week, two weeks
before the first date.
I want a bill. I'm trying to keep you long term. I ain't short term. I'm just not out here putting myself out there like that.
CL out here trying to get his last first date.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
Trying to see if you're trying to be Miss Butler. I'm trying to find out what's going on.
So a week.
No, it might take 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yeah, I'm slow. I'm not out of there like that.
Because I guess you got to give it some time to see if.
I got to find out if I like you. I don't know if I like you.
And if they go ghost, because people will go ghost.
Yeah, people do go ghost.
And women sometimes don't tell the truth. No women you know, Nick, and not you. But sometimes women don't tell the truth.
Women don't lie.
Every day they don't tell the truth.
You're right. They don't lie.
They just don't tell the truth.
They don't tell all the story.
We, you know, some parts may go missing, but we don't lie. We may omit a few things.
Okay.
But we don't lie.
Okay. Mm-hmm. that makes sense. So, but I like a little time to build and kind of see.
Okay.
That way I can figure out what you like, what you don't like, maybe what you're allergic to. If it's seafood or steak, or just the nuances of who you are as a person.
Okay, so as a woman, if I approach a guy and I ask, you know, how long it takes me to ask someone on a date, it depends on the guy.
Mm-hmm.
How much I'm interested in him.
Okay.
A week, I will say.
1 week?
Yeah, 1 week. After that week, if I don't see you again.
Hold on a second now. How many days did you wait to call? So is it a week from the call?
A week from the time you met? No, a week from the call.
Okay.
Well, I think, I could see that in that 2 week frame.
Mm-hmm.
2 to 3 week frame.
And I'm busy.
Because,
you know?
And that's the thing. Like, I think when I'm looking at work schedule and everything else we got going on.
Mm-hmm.
To build that much equity, I guess, to build on that.
You got
to
build equity.
It's probably about 2 to 3 weeks before an actual date.
Yeah, a week is kind of fast, isn't it? If you're a woman, you can say tomorrow.
Yeah.
Like, tomorrow. Yeah, I'm with it.
I'm with that.
No, but I mean, I think a week is sufficient.
It doesn't make you seem thirsty?
No, not at all.
But how much are you talking in this week?
Yeah. Because I'm talking every day?
Like, now that does depend. If we're not talking on a constant basis, then yeah, I can see 2 to 3 weeks.
That's what I'm saying.
But
like, I think
once we start that conversation and we're both interested, usually the text messages start, usually the phone conversations start, and you get on a routine.
Okay. Also, how long before the good morning gorgeous text?
Gorgeous.
Those usually happen the next morning.
The next morning.
For me.
So you can shoot that text the next morning?
That's usually, I don't have no control over their phones.
Oh, wow.
They usually do that the next morning.
So what do you text back? GM or?
Not GM.
No, you
I don't
text
like
back
GM.
Good morning? Yeah. Handsome? You hit him with a handsome?
Oh, talking about me sending a good morning.
No, you got to send something back.
You got to send something back.
Because I hope you don't send back. Okay.
Like,
no. Wow. Oh, GM.
When they say good morning, beautiful, I'll just say good morning.
That's try.
Good morning.
Because the text has no tone. That's try.
Yeah. So.
That's try.
So first conversation, first text? Or.
I don't like the text for the first, like. When I'm meeting somebody for the first time, I don't like to text.
So he shouldn't text immediately?
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
Call me.
Okay, now, just since we're talking about texting,
mm-hmm.
What if he met you via the internet?
Oh, yeah, that's
like, or social media wise?
Oh.
Because, you know, people get catfished and stuff, which I totally don't understand.
I don't understand in this day and age how you get catfished.
Yeah, I don't, because even social media have video call.
Okay.
Yeah, I can video call.
But what if I just like shouting your DMs and we just going back and forth DM-wise? No?
Ask me for my number.
Oh, so how?
We have to leave social media. If we don't
How long do you go back and forth?
On the DM before you ask, because you can't ask for the number off the top.
Or do you?
Yes, I do.
You ask for the number?
Yeah.
Day one?
Day one.
No, that's you. I'm talking about a guy.
The guy.
Oh, a guy.
Without seeming creepy.
Yeah.
Without seeming creepy.
No, if we're having a conversation and we're vibing and you ask me for my number, then that lets me know you want to talk to me a little bit more.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, how much back? It can't be like, hey, what's up? How you doing?
No, we have to actually be in conversation, in a good conversation.
Like, via text. Via DM?
Via DM. How far down the DM? Like, what is the number that you will put on it? As CL is always trying to make me put numbers on stuff.
Yeah, put numbers on it.
I can't exactly put a number on it, but I will say, like, if we started early in the day and we're basically at good night, talking to this person, you're more into them, you're like, hey, here's my number.
So one day of maybe texting for a while, mm-hmm. and then you ask for a number at the end.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because now you know you're interested in this person, and you can hold a conversation with this person.
But you haven't talked. You only type words. His friend can't type in words.
But that person can't call you either. So the next day,
okay,
if that person texts you, like, hey, good morning,
mm-hmm.
from the, you know, from their actual number and not just social media.
Not social media.
Now y'all are, you know, so like, okay.
By the end, you'd be like, hey, about to get off. Can I get you? You mind?
Yeah,
so
call you.
So we continue this conversation off of
social media. Definitely.
Okay.
Then that first conversation on their actual, you know, number, mm-hmm. versus social media.
Is that texting or is this talking?
No, actual talking.
Okay,
when
talking.
You call, that would be the first, the actual first conversation. That would be like you calling me for the first time once you meet me.
Okay. Okay.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
So y'all get that?
Yeah. Sounds complicated, but yeah.
It's okay. Not. It's so simple.
So the question now is, how we have 3 weeks in.
Mm-hmm.
How do we ask them out?
Are you a little sterner with your demands that says, I'm taking you out?
Oh.
Or do you ask?
Do you say, hey, are we going out Saturday?
No, nah, not like that.
Don't.
But just like, listen, it's time for me to see you.
Mm-mm.
It's time for me to see you. No. I need to see you. I want to take you to dinner.
That can work, depending on how much she likes you.
But
how much she's into you.
Asking that way will tell you how much she likes you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
To me, that's a little indicator. Like, okay, I can kind of call some shots.
And if she goes with it, like, okay.
Oh, she with it then.
Okay. Yeah. Now
she with it. Okay.
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 But you know, usually, ladies.
Mm-hmm.
I know some men have the tendency to, hey, don't make no plans on Friday. We're going out. Don't do that.
Those are Neanderthal type.
Yeah.
Cavemen.
Don't do that. But you'll be surprised how many men do.
They do?
That. Yeah.
Wow. Don't make any plans Saturday because we're going out.
We're going out.
Me and you, out. One day, one car.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And you'll be shocked how many women like that.
Women
like that.
Women enjoy men who take a control. Little control, a little amount of control.
I couldn't, but
okay. So,
but a lot of men do that.
So you should ask and let her get back with you.
Yeah, like kind of warm up to it. Like, hey, are you doing anything Friday?
Okay,
because you don't know her schedule. Like, you know, she may not tell you everything.
But if we've been talking for 3 mm-hmm. weeks.
Vibing.
We've been vibing for 3 weeks.
Vibing for 3 weeks.
It's a vibe.
It's okay.
If we've been vibing for 3 weeks, I kind of know your schedule. And we've probably been talking about
plans.
You might know her work schedule.
No.
You might know her schedule as far as if she has kids or friends. You know your schedule.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're planning a date and you're wanting to take her out, you may not be able to take her out that Friday. You may have to take her out that next Friday. She may have plans that she hasn't told you about yet.
Oh, no. She gets
paid every 2 weeks? Is that what
I'm saying? Not debating. Not debating that. What I'm saying is, as time goes, the frequency of phone calls go up. If the vibe is felt by both.
Okay, yeah.
The mm-hmm. frequency goes up. So
you learn through that frequency of calls.
Mm-hmm. Like, kind of what
pretty much, like, she don't work on Saturdays.
Yeah.
Or she don't work on the weekend.
Hey. But she may work that weekend.
No, and I'm not saying that you go, hey, we going out Saturday. What I'm saying is, like, through that, you may call. Y'all may talk, let's say, due to the first week you might have talked on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
Second week you might have talked on Tuesday, Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
And again on Sunday.
Okay.
That third week, the frequency has gone up now.
Mm-hmm.
You talked on Monday.
All right.
You might have missed Tuesday for whatever. Talked on Wednesday. And then on Wednesday, you go. She might bring up the fact that this week, you know, Friday, me and my girls going to do this. And it's that and third. And through the conversation, because it's later on in the week, you can kind of see where you might be able to fit in. Well, hey, I see. I don't think you're doing it. If you're doing it on Saturday, let's get together.
So you pose it as an option?
As an option.
Versus
for me.
Okay, you rather have an option.
I'd rather just, even if, because at that point, rather it's stern or the option, you know where you stand, because if she wants to spend time with you, she'll spend the time with you.
No, she wouldn't.
She wouldn't?
Why?
What would she do? I mean, like, don't base that. Like, if you're going to ask like that,
he need to put a little bass in his voice.
How did I ask?
No. I'm trying to make. No, you didn't ask wrong.
Leaving her an option, wiggle room.
Okay.
Like, if you know her Saturday is open, you're like, hey, I see you don't have anything to do Saturday. Would you like to go out, et cetera, et cetera?
So you prefer a man to be a little more...
The reason I'm framing the question that way is because although Saturday has not come up,
uh-huh,
I am not assuming that she has nothing to do on Saturday. It may not have come.
So you just give her an option.
So I'm giving her
But if she doesn't go with it and say, nah, not this weekend, that doesn't determine whether she likes you or not. She just may not feel like going out.
Okay, either way, no matter how I frame the question, if she doesn't feel like going out that weekend.
Well, no, it's not about going out. It's based upon how much she likes you.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, like you're basing that on how much she likes you, whether she goes on that date with you or not.
No, I'm not basing that. I'm just saying because she might not, for whatever reason, she may not want to go out
mm-hmm.
on Saturday. Hey, just kind of don't feel like it, whatever.
Uh-huh.
What I'm saying is if she... No matter what it was,
you're
saying we can't base whatever it is, how a person feels about you,
mm-hmm.
No matter what the response is. But if she wants to go out, she'll go out, no matter how you ask. That's okay. My thing. No matter how you frame it,
mm-hmm.
if a person wants to do something on that Saturday that they're free, then they'll do it. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Or we're not vibing.
We're vibing, but I think you gave an option. I was saying just ask directly.
Mm. Yeah. I mean, I get you're not wrong. I don't want you to feel like you're wrong.
I don't feel like I'm wrong.
things work.
Let's not get it twisted. Let's not do that.
I'm not saying that, you know, your approach is wrong. What I'm saying is, like, you can't determine that as her not wanting to spend time with you.
Okay.
Like, she may want to sit back and just enjoy your conversation for a little bit longer. Because, like, we have a choice as well.
Yeah, that's why I framed the question the way I did.
Yeah, because he gave, would you like to accompany me to...
Accompany?
Said accompany me to said restaurant? Or wherever we're going? No?
I don't know, that's good. Hey, you made plans for us.
Well, who else gonna make the plan?
Hey, I'm not mad.
I'm just asking,
women
who
love
else
that.
Make the
we
plan?
Always ask.
Women don't know where they want to eat at, so I'm not gonna ask you where you
do.
Yeah, right.
Oh no.
Oh yeah. You know what? You're right. The first week y'all together.
You don't know what you want to eat at all ever.
Forever.
Hey, what do you want to get for dinner? I don't know what you want.
No dinner. No, they say I'm hungry. You're hungry. What does that mean?
Okay,
that means I want to eat.
Okay,
feed me.
So where do you want to go?
I don't know.
I don't know what I got to taste for.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
And then
we pick it, and then it's going.
That's what? That's not it.
That's not what I want.
I had Chinese at work.
I just had that.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So once you get to the date,
itself.
Yes. You're preparing for the first date. Do you pick her up? Do you meet her there?
I think you leave it up to her, but I would always suggest you pick her up.
Really? I like to meet her.
I would. That's what I would prefer, but it may be safer for a woman to meet you there.
Yeah, I like to I like to meet them there just in case the date doesn't go well. So I have the option to leave.
You would run out on a date?
Not run out.
You would say, I'm out.
But, like, hey, okay.
But
like,
would you
I don't
give the waiter
to
a note and be like, I'm going to the bathroom.
No, once the date is over, you know, I don't have to ride in the car with him anymore. Like, I can go ahead and date stops and ends there.
Oh, okay. That's a new approach.
If he picks you up,
mm-hmm.
all right, you get to the place where, you know, dinner.
Yep.
Now you're having dinner. You're not really vibing anymore.
No vibe?
No vibe. You're starting to see things you don't like. Mm. It's starting to bother you. And you're like, okay, when is this going to be over? Now it's over. You're getting in the car.
Well, why can't you just say that?
You don't want to hurt someone's feelings.
Oh, okay. I'd rather you hurt my feelings than waste my time.
Well, maybe she's telling, like, you know, hey, you know, I'm not really into that, this, that, and the other.
Mm-hmm.
And the ride home could be awkward.
Okay, okay.
And you don't want to make it awkward, you know, so just, all right, go your separate ways after the dinner.
So if the woman chooses to ride with you, that means that could be a sign. That's one of the cues that she may be more comfortable
with you. Definitely.
So if she wants to meet you there,
yeah, 50-50? She's still unsure.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the conversation, and the date can determine where you go from there.
Yeah, yeah.
Is definitely.
Okay. On that date.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, go ahead. What you about to say?
Where should you go for this first date?
Never go to the movies.
Never go to the movies.
For a first date, never go to the movies.
I think that is 100% consensus.
Yeah, I don't now, like
that. That is the worst first date you could do.
Now, yes and no. If we had dinner first and then we decide to catch a movie,
mm-hmm.
it's okay. But I wouldn't just go to the movie.
Hey, yeah, let's catch a movie.
Yeah, I wouldn't just catch a movie as the...
Yeah, I think that would be like a third date.
Third date?
Mm-hmm.
So you couldn't have part A of that date and it be a movie?
Yeah, I could. Like, if we had dinner first... Then the movie, yeah, that's fine. But okay. To just go to the movies, movie, yeah, no.
Okay.
So dinner is the kind of the...
It's a go-to.
It's the go-to for first.
I think, unless you have... Women want to eat.
Yeah, we want to
eat. They feel disrespected when you don't feed them.
Yeah.
But you could go to Top Golf or something to see, you know... About if she's athletic, you know.
No 4-for-4s.
No, definitely no 4-for-4.
Listen, we know where I stand on the first date. I mean,
but you could do. This. Could you do bowling?
Yeah, bowling, definitely.
Top golf.
I was thinking about.
I love activities like that on the first date.
I was
date,
thinking
actually.
About like an escape room.
Escape room?
Yeah.
Okay.
That would be good too.
That's good. I've never been to an escape room.
I've never been.
You
got
to communicate with one another. You got to be a team to kind of get out of there.
Okay.
So it's kind of, I've never been.
But for a first date, I don't know about that with an escape room. You being stuck in a room with someone that you're trying to get to know.
Is that how it works?
No, it's like basically from my understanding is there's some kind of crisis in the world.
No, is there a group or is it just you and her?
No, it could be, you can do it.
As a group or as a group.
Or it could be just you and her.
Okay.
And the reason why I think it would be good is you get to see a person in problem solving skills, and it lets you kind of be in a more laid back environment, and it may be more of a, as we get to a little bit later, some icebreakers and stuff like that on the date.
Okay.
And I think if you grab something to eat after doing that, you've established some type of something between the two of you.
Hopefully.
Because you're able kind of to lay back and there's no stress of a conversation that has to be had, so to speak. The awkwardness is kind of taken out of it because you're kind of trying to accomplish something, so to speak, if that makes sense.
Okay.
That's my thought process.
That's a suggestion.
Yes.
Yeah. Any suggestions or any?
I like the bowling thing.
Like bowling.
Yeah, I love the bowling. Because you can communicate, you can eat.
Mm-hmm.
And bowl. You can do all that in one setting.
Okay.
And it doesn't have to be, okay, we're going to go here, we're going to go there. And with bowling, is just, we're playing a game, we're having fun, and it's not too hard.
Okay. Well, I don't know. I've had one of those go left on me, so.
What, you lost to a lady?
No, the date was just.
What'd y'all do?
We was bowling.
Did she start winning?
No. Uh-uh. Oh, no, I don't lose in bowling.
Okay.
Let's be real here.
Okay.
Nah, I can bowl. But, like, midway through, like, we paid for, like, 3-4 games, something like that. Same concept. We're going to order some food.
She must.
We're going to bowl. Is that what she musty?
Yeah, she can.
Nah, she didn't.
That's a turn off.
Going back a couple episodes.
I'm just saying, she didn't start off that way, but three games of bowling.
Yeah, no,
it get kind of sweaty.
But midway through game one, the conversation and everything was so dry.
Well, I just think that might be too active.
Yeah, like, it was just because it's like there's a break in. While I'm up there bowling,
she's back there.
She's back there sitting. And then as you're going back and forth, sometimes you may sit. We sat and talk here and there.
Okay.
But for the most part, it was a lot of passing. Okay, it's my turn. Okay, it's my turn.
So, there was no talking, no there cheering was,
we,
on.
We did.
See, because I don't like to get
of,
it.
We like, kind of talked, and I think that bowling leaves that option for non-interaction if the date is going left. And so that's why I never really, unless I was in a relationship with someone, had gone bowling again as a date in the
OU
phase.
Yeah.
And I just.
That's why I said it's a good thing because, well, I mean, this was just what my experience. It was our first date. I didn't even know we were going. We just went, which was fun. We talked, we cheered each other on. He even showed me how to bowl correctly.
Oh, he did that. He did pull that old classic.
Yeah.
Okay.
Teaching
you how to play pool.
It was fun. Yeah. Basically, he made it fun versus it being competitive.
So he touched you.
He did.
And you like it. And she like
you bringing up something. Now, I think playing a game of pool
gives you more time to talk.
Pool would be a little bit better than bowling.
Okay.
I would agree. I
both of them equally is good, but I think pool is less active than...
Yeah, and you're around the table, small, confined space, so
to speak. Well, unless it turns into one of those 1960 movies where you bump a guy.
Now you got a brouhaha.
And the only thing about pool...
Be tough in front of
you. The only thing about pool on the first date, I mean, you have to go to a bar.
No, it's pool halls.
No, this...
I know where I live, there are places that just have pool.
There's pool tables.
It's a bar far off, but it's just billiards.
You know, you can have some drinks.
Excuse me, billiards.
Some food.
It's not pool.
Yeah, billiards.
Billiards. It's a billiards hall.
Have some
pool. Yeah, it's a little fancy.
Because there was a place in Greenville, as a matter of fact, has pool tables, and they sell food, and you got a waitress, and, you know, they don't have seats. Chairs, I'm sorry, but, you know, it's got the little high-top tables you can stand at.
Okay.
Get your food and have your drinks and play
pool. So is Dave and Buster's good? I'm against Dave and Buster's, but.
And yeah, I don't.
Too loud.
I like Dave and Buster's too loud.
Okay, too loud?
Too loud.
Yeah.
Okay. Too what loud. Dave and Buster's. What else is there? Pool.
What do you think about?
Oh, I know what I don't like.
What?
Wine and design.
Oh.
I don't like. That's for girlfriends.
Yeah, it is for
that's
your girlfriends.
You wouldn't go dudes. Wine design.
That's for a relationship. That's once you get in a relationship.
That's not
you got to be deep in a relationship.
Couple things you do together.
On the verge of marriage. Like, it's got to be.
Yeah, I'm talking year four. I'm not talking first 4 years. Like, no wine and design.
Yeah, no, we're not. We're not designing anything.
Yeah, I don't like
it. How do y'all feel about first date being I can't even bring it up.
What is it?
But bringing crowds, basically.
Bringing
a group date.
Doing a group date
for your first date? We're not 13.
No.
I need to get you by yourself.
I mean, some women do feel like, you know, bringing my friends on my date make it more comfortable.
Yeah, y'all be there by yourself. Grumbling adult.
Yeah, I'm not.
And you know how much food costs for everybody?
Hey.
Because or drinks or?
You're paying for the friends too?
You got to.
Of course.
I'm talking about like on a double date. Boom. There you go.
A double date?
Yeah, like a double date for a first
date. Okay, let me ask you this. Are me and the two men friends or the two women friends? Because I'm not going on a double date with none of my friends.
They're not going to set the bar?
They're going to go too far.
They're going to go too far?
Yeah, it's going to get personal at some point.
You remember back then when you did so and so?
Yeah. You remember when you was with Sherry? Hey, man, that's not to be talked about now.
It's the last time when you was with that other girl.
Yeah. This like his thing. He like double dating with girls, right? And I'm like, So you don't want that.
That does get kind of awkward. especially if the guys are friends and not the females. Yeah. Because now,
you know,
like,
women have a harder time making friends.
We have a harder time communicating together, so it kind of makes it awkward.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I see that.
Yeah.
I just don't. Yeah. Well, we're gonna take a second and get a commercial in from the Defy Life Network. We'll be back in 2 and 2.
Okay.
2 and 2.
Good news, people. Defy Life Gear now has your favorite podcast t-shirts. If you're a fan of anything, everything, and nothing with Lynn and Kim, the DJ Blaze radio show, relationship status, take a knee for Marvel vs. DC, the Staley and English show, or the Defy Life podcast, we've got you covered. Defy Life podcast gear only at DefyLifeGear.com.
Okay, and we're back.
We're back like we never left before.
Because we didn't leave.
We didn't leave. We still here. We was waiting on y'all.
Yeah, as a commercial said, man, go ahead and visit DefyLifeGear.com and get that relationship status podcast t-shirt.
That's right. Two colors to choose from.
That red and that blue. Go ahead and get you one.
Okay. I think I'm going to get the blue.
You get the blue?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
So, mm-hmm. Back to places.
Places.
What about places you shouldn't? And we already said the movies is one.
Places you shouldn't.
I wouldn't go like golf cart racing.
Go kart racing. Like,
why?
I mean, that's fun. Nah, women can get disheveled. Somebody could hit her.
True.
And then their hair mess. I just don't want to be too physical.
How about paintball shooting?
That's too physical for me.
Too physical.
What about amusement parks?
If that's what she's into, me personally, I could take it or leave it. I'm adaptable, but I wouldn't want to do that.
I don't know about a first date at an amusement park.
Unless that's just her thing. Like, if she's just big on
heroines
or something.
If she's like a daredevil and you, like, y'all conversation is, you know, she likes to do outrageous stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yes, like, I love roller coasters.
Yeah, like, she's a big daredevil.
But she would have to really like that.
Yeah.
I wouldn't.
Yeah, because if she doesn't.
But you also have to make sure she's comfortable doing that with you.
Yeah. And the person has to be active. Because, like, I don't want to go to the amusement park and be like, hey, let's do this.
And you want to feed her. Yeah.
My feet hurt. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Come dress comfortable. I'm going in swim shoes. And
oh, wow.
And,
swim shoes. Should you go swimming?
You're going to get on the water lot. The swim water truck, ride.
I'm
right?
getting on
the
every ride. I ride every ride.
Okay.
Right. Kiddie rides and all.
Okay. Wow.
I'm on everything.
You on everything. Something too active, I wouldn't
jet
say
skis.
No. Unless you met her in Jamaica or Aruba or Tampa. Or Tampa, Florida.
Or Miami.
Somewhere.
I think a trip, like, outside of your city. Going
as
too
a date,
far.
As a first date?
Oh, God, yes. No, we ain't going.
Going to the beach on a first date.
Oh, yeah. No, we ain't going there.
Going somewhere 30 minutes or an hour out of your way.
No. Okay, so you suggest not having a long car ride on the first date.
Definitely. Because, I mean.
Concert? No?
No.
No, no, no.
No concert?
No, no concert.
No.
First off, I hate concerts, so.
Okay.
I can't go to a concert.
What if that's her thing, like concerts?
Yeah, like if it's her thing, I still I love concerts.
Yeah, no,
but
I'm not going
on the first date.
Go have fun.
I'm not able to get to know you. I need to talk to you. I want to.
There's no interaction.
Yeah, we're just dancing to music we like. That's like going to a club.
Yeah, that comedy shows. Like, I just think all that stuff is just
comedy
for a
show
first date.
Yeah,
no.
that's a little bit out.
Okay.
What about once you're sitting down for dinner?
Mm-hmm.
You're communicating.
You're talking.
Yeah. What are some icebreakers?
Icebreakers. So I guess we gotta get that awkwardness out.
Yeah.
That initial awkwardness. Let's get it. And I guess since we're at dinner.
At dinner.
Okay. So it's not one of these activities that we said before.
Mm-hmm.
Which is at dinner.
Well, the easiest icebreaker for probably any man to woman is to just ask the woman one or two questions.
What?
Ask her about herself or ask her how she feels about something. And just sit back.
Yeah.
Eat your whole meal. Relax.
Wait, before we get to that.
She's going to tell you everything you want to know.
Before we get to that.
Okay.
At dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Do you sit across from or next to?
I think across from. Across. Because I don't want women touching me like that initially.
I like next to.
Okay. So you already ready to be romantic?
I'm a next to.
Yeah. Wow, you a fast mover.
I'm not a fast mover. I just
slick talker, fast mover.
We can sit there. We can sit there and talk and observe the world go by from the same vantage point.
I'm gonna say across. I need to watch it. I don't really know it.
Yeah,
she could be a thief. I don't know.
In your pocket.
Yeah,
I think it just kind of depends on who you are.
Yeah, it does. It does. It does.
Sit across from me.
It does.
Now, I just sitting across just seems so business dealish.
Oh, this
a little impersonal.
This is a business transaction.
It is.
Initially,
I'm getting to know you.
Matters of the heart are.
You're
business
selling yourself to me right now.
Yeah, and you know the goods. The goods. Yeah. Are good. The goods are good.
The goods are good.
The goods are all good.
Yeah. Now, with those icebreakers, there's some common W's you can use.
Like what? So intrigued.
Who?
Right now.
When? How? Where? And why? Start any conversation.
True.
You can just run through.
Common.
Yeah. You can. That'll open up. Frame them however you want to frame it. Just learn those W's. And you can go with the one H. How? How did that happen? No. And you just let the conversation flow. So you don't, you know.
I think it's, for me, as a woman with an icebreaker, if a guy is into sports, that's easy for me because I'll just ask him, oh, who's your favorite teams? Oh, I like LeBron. I like this. I like that one. Oh, really?
Yeah,
Yeah.
Oh,
I love that.
If you ask me about sports, it's going to get complicated. Yeah. I have a love-hate relationship with sports.
Really? And see, that's going to start a conversation.
It's going to be too deep for her. She's going to be like, nah.
It might get boring.
Yeah. But you know, you can ask those. Those are good basic conversation starters.
Yeah.
So once you have established and you broke the ice, where now, Nique? You're still breaking the ice. So how do you keep the conversation going?
It gets that awkward, dead silent.
It shouldn't get silent. The guy has to have a plan.
There should never be any silence.
No.
But if you plan a date, shouldn't you plan it all the way through? What kind of conversation?
I would.
How not to, you know, for it to go boring?
I would.
Then how would you handle it?
First of all, I would probably turn my personality down a little so she can be calm. So it wouldn't overwhelm her. Because when she's overwhelmed, I mean, we never know where the evening's going to go. So I would dial it back a little bit. I wouldn't give it a full CL-ism. But I would really try to find out about her.
Okay, so you would ask her
a lot of questions about how she feels, what she likes, what she dislikes. Does she have a pet?
But I mean, you already have those you should have already had those conversations on the phone.
Well, you should, but you got to save something.
You got to save something for the face to face.
Okay, face to face.
But something like, does she have a pet?
Yeah,
should have been asked over the phone. But you can go into, oh, how's your pet?
No, I will not. No, pets are up front because if she's really into her pet,
I'm out.
They try to act.
I'm out.
You out?
I'm out.
No cats, no dogs.
She got a pet, I'm out.
Yeah. People are usually passionate about their animals, sometimes more passionate than people.
I'm out.
Yeah, and you're right. If she has too many cats, you should be out.
The cat lady.
Yeah, the cat lady. Yeah. Cat lady wasn't always old.
That's why she's single.
Yeah.
I was wondering why you're single.
With animals, it is kind of a turn off with certain animals. I will.
Really?
Yeah.
So if a guy has a pet ferret, you would be like, what is wrong with
you? No, but if he has like a pit bull and he's like, oh yeah, I breed dogs. And he just breeds those.
What's wrong with that?
I don't know. It's just my personal preference.
Let's see if he said he had a rat. Like a hamster.
I like a hamster. Serial killer.
Why do you have a hamster? You're a grown man with a hamster.
Not manly enough for you.
I can't get with. Nah, pet lovers, I'm out.
Really? Why?
Yeah, I'm out.
That's different.
That is different.
I'm out.
So a girl says, oh yeah,
I have a cat and I love my cat. And that means the cat in the bed, the dog in the bed.
Well, not all.
You have outside cats, don't you?
Yeah.
When people love their pet and the pet's in the house, That baby in that bed.
Well, I wouldn't want a dog in the bed, but I mean, a dog
but,
in the
But I mean, some fine. Dogs are in the bed, especially if they're a house dog.
And they now, jumping all over
they don't
the
have their own bed?
So they might have their own bed, but if she's been living by herself,
yeah.
If she's been living by herself,
you see why this is a great icebreaker. Yeah. So I mean, different directions we're going about animals.
No, I'd be like, right then I might as well go and pay for the.
Check. What if she has a bird?
A bird.
Yeah,
I'm gonna ask her what the hell is
wrong. You got a bird.
You got a bird. Who gets a bird?
Maybe I don't know.
I know not one person with a bird.
I had a parrot.
I don't either. Well, that was little. I might have had a parrot.
No, I had a parrot. Yeah, I had a parrot.
As an adult?
Yeah.
Okay, no. I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, it is.
It is okay.
Well, what is wrong with
so you? So you are judging people who have parrots?
Yes, I am. Okay. I can deal with a fish. You got a fish?
Okay.
What's the difference between a fish and a bird?
I don't know. It's not my thing.
If it's a fish, we good with a fish.
Good with a fish.
Yeah, a parrot gonna say stuff back, whatever.
No, that's like a car. That's like them real parrots. Like
yeah, real, $2,000
parrots. Not no Walmart $14 parrots.
Little those yellow birds.
Don't talk.
No.
They do something.
They bird. They parrot.
Do something annoying.
They parrot.
Yeah, they.
Whatever they do is parrot.
Yeah, wake up in the middle of the night. And
yeah.
I don't want none of that.
See? Now by this time, you've already gotten to the appetizer.
Yeah. Do you order an appetizer?
Yes. Gotta order
appetizers. Yeah, you let her order appetizers. You might order one. I don't usually order appetizers.
Do you let her? Well, I wanted to ask y'all this. This when I came up with this topic. I had a guy ask me on a date, but he wanted complete control over the date and he ordered for me.
Run.
What? What do you go cycles.com for your dates? What is crazy people? Why would you go to that website again, Nique? Let it go. Let that go. No, that's not a good website.
I am not telling y'all.
It's,
no more
it's
about
only Christian Mingle dating. For you from here on out.
Christian Mingle.
That's it. No Plenty that's of Fish. It. None of that.
Because
I don't know Plenty of Fish.
You want to complete? She want like some 50 Shades of.
No, he wanted he wanted complete control. He was like, I want to order for you. Based off of our conversation.
Or did he just say he went and asked you or he just
came in?
No, he wildin'.
Yeah, he was like, can I order for you?
He's
like, but did you let him order for you?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, so, I mean, you liked it.
Yeah, I did.
Well, Nique. We're gonna have to just hit you with a to be continued on this
We're gonna go ahead and go to be continued and we'll pick it up next week.
Same bat time, same bat channel. It's your host CL Butler.
And Nique Crew.
And your boy Yusuf. And once again we wanna thank you for listening to the show. Remember, you can catch us on all podcast platforms. If you would like to leave a comment, email us at rsp@godefylife.com and follow us on all social media platforms at RELSTAT Podcast. That is RELSTAT Podcast. And don't forget to like, comment, share, and 5-star rate.
Welcome to the Anything, Everything, and Nothing podcast with Lynn and Kim. Join us as we discuss the latest in everything from entertainment and current events to the craziness that is our real life.
Let's laugh, let's live, let's talk about it. New episode every Tuesday on the Defy Life Podcast Network. And remember, if you're not defying life, then what are you doing? Lynn and Kim.